Good afternoon, students. Welcome back to our class, that is Innovation Management. Today we are going to talk on the Innovation Management, that means Introduction to Innovation. This is the fourth unit of Innovation Management topic. In this, today we are going to learn about the meaning, definition and importance of innovation. Second thing, types of innovations, success and unsuccessful of innovations, models of innovations. That's it. Before that, going to start the class, I want to just bring your minds towards the class. See, innovation means what? It is creating the idea and implementing the idea, and successfully that idea should have to get realized in the company or output. So, for the sake of innovating the new product, that means those ideas should have to be implemented on the product, process or service. Now, innovation is a process and outcome of creating something new, which is also of value. Innovation involves the whole process from opportunity identification, ideation or invention to development, prototyping, production, marketing and sales. While entrepreneurship only needs to involve commercial, as been mentioned by Computer. So innovation, it involves the whole process of opportunity. What are the opportunities will be there? We have to identify those opportunities, and we have to identify the ideation, and we have to invention. That means we have to implement that idea, and development should be there. Prototyping should be there. Now, innovation means development and technology should be there. If you understand this picture, you can able to understand innovation talks about the development with the help of technology. How you are going to get the development with the help of adding or utilizing the technology. Then only innovation is taking place or it is creating. Now, meaning of innovation. Any creative idea getting implemented or realized successfully is innovation. That means whatever the idea we are creating, it should have to get implemented and it should have to realize successfully. That means it should have to after implementing, we have to get the 100% result of that idea, and the company should have to get plus point, that means profit side. Then only it is known as a new invention or innovation. Now, definition: innovation is the creation, development and implementation of a new product, process or service. As early in the first lab, as I was saying you that, innovation means what? It is in creation, creating of the new idea, developing those ideas, adding some new things in that idea and implementing those ideas. After implementing those ideas, where we have to implement those ideas? On the product or process or on service. And after that, what will happen? And it is the main aim of implementing those ideas, when we are getting the realization or the effective or efficiency advantage of that product, then it is known as an innovation. Or means another side, when we are implementing those ideas and we are getting the result, positive result to the company or organization or an individual, and we are getting some new things or the profits with those ideas, then only it is known as an innovation. Now, coming to another slide, here in a simple parlance, innovation means any creative idea, renewing, changing or creating more effective process, products or ways of doing things. That means renewing, changing or creating more effective processes. After one process, we have to utilize another process or new process. With the help of new process also, we can generate the new products or new service. A small business possibly having a thought of process and courage to try a new strategy or tool. Implementing a new CRM system. CRM means what here? Customer relationship management. How you are going to manage a new. That means any implementing a new system or a process or a product or a service. Now trying a new sales approach. What are the new sales approach? How you are going to bring the new approach in the sales. All these things will come under the innovation. So I hope students will understand the meaning and definition of innovation. Now we'll talk about the importance of innovation. So here are some important points why innovation is important. It brings effectively achieving business growth goals. That means first thing is, with the help of innovation, we'll get the effective goals. We will reach to that. That means the business will reach to the effective goals. Another thing, it will increase the productivity and increase the profitability. That means when we are production will be high, automatically the profit or the production will be high and profit will also be high. Third one, effectively responding to industry disruptors and increasing market share. Whatever the disturbance are, problems created, people's are, things will be there. It will affect, it will respond effectively and increase market share. So another thing, it will respond quickly for the external challenges and developing human resources with the help of technological resources to do things differently. So these are the very, very important terms why innovation is important. If you see on in the picture, the importance of innovation talks how a number of different disciplines contribute to our understanding of the innovation process. See, creative individuals. In this, scientific and technological development lead to knowledge inputs. What it may be there. Now, the firms develop the knowledge. Here, the individuals are developing the, creating the knowledge. Here, the firms develop knowledge, process, and products. So, we will come to, then the firms, society. What the society are bringing the new changes with the firms, architecture, and external linkage. So, all these things is creating a web, and this part is known as an innovation management. What are the things are needed for the individual customer? What are the things are the companies providing? Are it is effectively, or it is bringing new change in the minds of the society, I mean in the customers or in the individuals or the firms. So all these things are taking place. So this is important. Identifying the customers' problems, fulfilling the needs of the customers or consumers, bringing the new ideas with the help of the technologies and features to save the time, money, efforts, costs of company as well as the customer. Now, what are the benefits of innovation? Now, it is more effectively work processes, saving time and money. It increases customer satisfaction level. It is a staff motivation and competitive advantages. Now, innovation can be a catalyst for the growth and success of your business and help you adopt and grow in the marketplace. If you see here, innovation is helping. What is the product? It is will bring the innovation in the product, in the process, in the organization, and in the market also. These four combinations are comes under the innovation process. Now, if you see here, the most innovative companies, these are the 50. That means from by 2020, I have just selected Fortune Pharma's 50 companies who are utilizing the innovation process, and they are bringing new changes, new ideas in the company and building up the profitable chances effectively with solving the internal and external problems. Yes. See here, Amazon, Microsoft, Samsung, Huawei, IBM, Sony, Facebook, Walmart, Netflix, Hitachi, Airbus, Bosch, P&G, Toyota, these are the examples, Volvo, Philips, these are the examples, Apple, first of all, Apple, Johnson & Johnson, HP, Netflix, Target, what it may be, Oracle, these are the best example, I mean companies who are utilizing innovative terms according to the time and situations. Now, we will talk about the models of innovations. We are having four models of innovation. First one is technology pull, push model, market pull model, coupling model, interactive model. First, when the innovation started in the first generation, it is not technology push. When the technology is coming, they used to push the product, whatever the thing are coming. And simple radical innovation will be there. Coming to the second generation, market pull, what the market is pulling towards us, it is used to take this. And simple increment, little bit incrementation was there in the innovation. Coming to the third generation, this simple radical increment innovation, feedbacks between phases, that means functional areas like research and development, marketing and manufacturing. That is coupling model takes place. And Fourth generation interactive model, what actor networking parallel phases is taking place. If you see in the picture, that means 1950s and 60s technology, they used to push whatever the manufacturer, they used to push to sell to the in the market. But 1970, they used to pull it. What the marketing is needed, what the user is using in the marketing, research and development, manufacturing. In the last class or in the marketing, I had explained you what is pull and push strategy. The same thing was here. They have understand it and they are working on it. Now, innovation and invention. First, we have to understand what do you mean by innovation and invention. Invention is the creation of a product or introduction of a process for the first time. Like Thomas Alva Edison was an inventor of an electrical bulb. Innovation. Innovation happens when someone improves on or makes a significant contribution to something that has already been invented. Steve Jobs was an inventor. That means invention is for the first time when a person has been invented. Innovation means after doing the invention, he or she may be improving some other thing or some contributing some other significance in that product. That is known as invented or innovation. Now, here is a difference between an invention and innovation. A new concept or product that derive from individuals' ideas or from scientific research or by the firm is known as invention. Coming to the innovation, commercialization of the inventions itself, innovation is composed of two parts. One is the generation of an idea or invention, and second one, the conversion of that invention into a business or other useful application. So that's why innovation is equal to invention plus exploitation. I hope students you understand here. I will show you one small pick, some more important. Yeah, invention, how you are going to describe it? Let's have a look. Innovation can be described as the introduction of a new product line or device or ideology that is based on study and experimentation. Companies get inventions registered in their own name by the virtue of patents. And patents reserves the right of ownership of the invention with its inventor for a particular period of time, hence ensuring that the invention is not misused. What did you understand? The thing is here, invention can be described, it means introduction of a new product line in the market or new ideology or new device that is based on study and experiment. That is called innovations. That means company gets inventions over here. And that will be registered with their its own name and with its own patents and trademarks. Yeah. What are the significance of inventions? Some points here are like inventions are a proof of the creditability of scientific knowledge. Inventions have unexpected results. Sometimes invention should be the leading priority. Invention is the building block for innovation. Invention requires skill. So what's it here? If I give for these points, I'll give a suitable example to you so you are able to understand. See, inventions are the proof of creditability of scientific knowledge. That means it will, the credit goes to so and so person, we used to say. To the scientist, when he is going to invent something new, then he is called a scientist, or it is the credit goes to the scientific knowledge. And the when he or she has invented a new thing, then the result will be unexpected. And it will be a leading priority and it will block off innovation, that means invention. And who has invented this thing, he needs a good skill, or he may be having a good skill. Nikola Tesla, he was an eccentric inventor and an exceptional scientist who made major inventions like alternating current, remote control, neon lamps, three-phase power, and induction motor, and many more which are used today in day-to-day life. So what are the things? Who is he? He is a scientist. The credit goes to him. You agree? Yes. He has given unexpected results to us. Yes. He is a leading priority. That means his invention has bring a leading priority to the society. And his block, that means his invention in the block, building block for the innovation. And he is a skillful person. All these things are there. And these are the significance of invention. Now we'll talk about innovation. What is innovation? How can we describe the innovation? Innovation can be described as a value addition to a product line device or ideology by alternating their basics for delivering greater value to the customer and survive in a persistently innovating environment. Innovation requires an extensive study and research, the result of which should be superior to the competitors. Thus, invention is a complex process. So, what is happening in the innovations? We require an extensive study and research, and the result will be superior to the competitors. More than that means the what the competitor is using, we need more superior result with our product. So, these are the things where we are focusing on it. Next, what are the significance of innovation? The significance of innovations can be: invention is a major contribution to the growth of a company. That means for every company they need some innovations, and innovations attracts the best talents. So what will happen in the innovations? You'll, after having a skillful person, he will bring out his talent and he will show in the modification of the product, and he requires different kinds of skills like changing the color, pattern, taste, preference, behavior. Next, innovation gives technical advantage. Will bring a new technical advantage in this. An example, Apple. When Steve Jobs returned in 1997, he led Apple to apogee of success through remarkable innovations like iPhone, iPad, and many other innovations. In 1997, he had done iPhone was there, and no people had believed, but after 10 years or 12 years, many people's, that means his dream has came to truth. Many people are using iPhone, iPad, and many other innovations. So this is called the signification of innovations. Now, what is a successful and unsuccessful innovations? Successful innovations, I mean successful innovations for the entrepreneurs are, that means they will be creative and innovative. They are the positive themselves in shifting of new markets or old markets, creating the new products. They'll create new process. They'll create new delivery. What are the innovation of unsuccessful entrepreneurs? That poor managers will be there, low work ethic will be there, inefficient, failure to plan and prepare, poor money managers. All these are the things where the story will talk. Now, here on the screen, you may have, we are having 12 points which talks about the successful and unsuccessful story. First, we'll go with the successful entrepreneurs. That means it will be, they will having a strategic plan. They will have the return of investment. They will plan for the long time. The people will hire for the better. That means quality people, they will hire the employees. They'll take the responsibility of their failures. They will give due credits to others. That means whatever the things are coming, due credits they are going to fulfill. They'll give, they will consider change as an opportunity. And they will do business in to make a differences. They will love to learn new things and share them to others. They will not fight with others. They will not show brightness or proudness over there. And they will think in a positive way. They will never give up with the failures what they are coming. They will prepare for failures for success when or till success comes. And the same thing, those are the other things are the opposite in the unsuccessful entrepreneur. They will be blame on others. They will start an trenderous business, start a hot or trending business. They will create unnecessary plans. That means they will not concern about the cost of investment. They will think that the people or the employees are their slave workers. They will do business to make money. They will decide to call or quit when failures comes. They'll relax and celebrate too much when success comes. All these are the stories of unsuccess innovation, unsuccess entrepreneurs innovations. Now, types of innovations. So, what are the types of innovation we are having? First, product innovation, process innovation, organizational innovations, management innovation, production innovation, marketing or commercial innovation. The last one is service innovation. Now we will discuss a brief introduction, but one by one, about the product innovation. What is product innovation? The product innovation is nothing but, it's talk about, it's defined as the development of a new product, changes in design to establish products, or use of new materials or components in the manufacturing manufacturers of establishment products. That means what is happening in the product innovation? They bring the new changes in the product design, taste, performance, or the shape, size, color, other things. So these are the things will come in the product innovation. Coming to the process innovation, what they will do? A process innovation is the implementation of a new or significantly improved production or delivery method. This includes significant changes in techniques, equipment, and other software. So in the process, what will happen? They will change the new, they will bring some new changes in techniques at the time of manufacturing the goods or delivering the services with the help of equipment or software. Next, organizational innovations. So what happening in the organization? Organization is nothing but the firm or a company. Implementation of a new organization method in the firm's business practices, in the organization of its workplace, or in its external relations to improve the use of knowledge, workflows efficiently, or quality of goods or service. So many big companies or organizations nowadays, they are bringing new innovations in their firms so that the work can go smoothly. They are bringing new ideologies, and they are focusing on the quality of goods or services, and they are building on the external relationship, or they are bringing the peace in the workplace, or they are bringing the quality persons in their organizations to bring the quality output of their product. So these were things. Now, management innovations. What do you mean by management innovations? Management means what? What are the functions of management? Planning, organizing, coordinating, directing, staffing, all these things were there. Already you have learned in your HR. So here in the management, the innovation management, that means innovation is also coming here as it's in combination of the management of innovations, process, and change management. It refers to the product, business process, marketing, and organizational innovations. What are the new changes are bringing? You have to bring in the organizations also. Depending on the time and situation, you have to go for it. Now, production innovation. What do you mean by production innovation? Production innovation is a concept that is going to describe ongoing and re-engineering process. That means in the production, what is going on and what are the new engineering or technical terms should have to come for manufacturing that product, or what sort of technical machines are the updated or very fast output giving machines are should be utilized for the core organizational culture in itself. Its aim is to evolve product and production engineering from prevalent trends of continuous improvement towards continuous innovations. So what is the main aim? Its main aim is to offer or to evolve product and production engineering. Who are the product engineer and who are the production engineer? The process will take place. How the production is taking place? The engineers will go for the technical term. All these things will come in the production innovation. Now, marketing innovation. Here, marketing innovation, what are the new inventions are coming in the marketing? Who the marketer should have to go for the research and should have to go for it. Either they have to go, they have to see either the packaging level is getting difference. Nowadays, the packaging, many people used to pack the goods in the boxes, in the tin box or bottle. Now, the sachets are coming, the plastic packets are coming. Very, very different way are coming. So all this knowledge should have to be bring, and the innovation should have to come into the market or into the organization for developing the marketing innovations. So how the product is designing, how the product is packaging, how the product is getting placement, how the product is getting promotion, how the product should be get price, all these things will be comes under the marketing innovation. Now, service innovation. The last one is the service innovation. How that means what do you mean by service innovation? This means service or product, that means service process that is based on some technology or some systematic method in services. However, the innovation does not necessarily relate to the novelty of the technology, but itself the innovation often lies in the non-technical areas also. That means how the service is given by us to the customer, and sometimes when the innovation, that means non-technical areas will be there, then how we are going to novelty over there. So all these things should have to be taken place over there. So at last, I want to say you that a service innovation is nothing but what are the new things should have to be generated in the service. For example, if you are having laborers who are not educated and they are unskilled, and how they are behaving and performing towards our customers. Are they are fulfilling, are they are following up properly, are they are closing the customers in a polite way or not, are they are reaching or delivering the goods in time with the effective packaging and with effective time and delivering each and everything in proper way or not. All these circumstances will come under the innovation, service innovations. I hope students you have understand the topic, and please mention your attendance in the comment box. Thank you. Have a nice day.